James, stop. James, stop.
So, first of all, thank you for inviting us to this demonstration. Inviting us to, we are from the traditional Hong Kong Wing Chun of the Jiuwen village. So what we'll do today is, first of all, we'll do a little demonstration on the first form of Wing Chun, and then we will explain a little bit what we do about qi sao, the sticky hands or sticky hands, yeah?
Okay, thank you.
That was the first form of Wing Chun Kobinja, like this is your wing now. And we were now going to demonstrate it, explain it a little bit about the sticking hands and the kind of cheese. So, like, in Tai Chi, we have pushing hands as well. So, in Wing Chun, we have what we call sticking hands, or sticking the cheese out. So, they are now starting off with single sticking hand, single cheese. So, what is this for? We spend a lot of time in sticking hand. What are we actually doing? A lot of people think, okay, this is only a practicing drill. But it is a lot more than that. First of all, it's also a very important teaching tool. So the teacher uses this drill to basically manipulate the student's hand to correct places. So once again, managing the hand position. So if the hands are in the correct position, remember that they don't need to use reaction to chase hands. That's objective number one. And over time, you can actually use this. This becomes a very important fighting skill set in Wing Chun. For a simple reason. Simply because even if your hand is in perfect position in the moment of time, and you need to set your opponent's hand perfectly, every opportunity, you will go into a tangled situation. For example, say if I initiate a strike, striking someone. I strike once, he intercepts, I strike again, now we're in the tangled position. Or even if the opponent strikes with the intercept, they strike it once, I strike again, now we're in the tangled position. So this tangled position is inevitable. So it is very, very important. We need to learn and train what we're going to do in this tangled position. So if your hands are in the correct position, they wouldn't even be able to touch you, grab you, strike you. So if you look at them now, all the hands should be jamming up in the position, none of them should even be able to touch each other. But even if your hands are in the perfect position, your opponent will still try to manipulate your hands into the correct position. Yeah? So we have to learn how to recover our hand position into the correct position. One last problem. It's also when you intercept your opponent in this tangled position, your opponent can be very aggressive. They can charge you like a bull. So we will have to learn what to use power against power, force against force. So what we try to do is we use the aggression and force against our opponent. We try to manipulate the energy, and our objective is to make our opponent lose their balance. And once they lose their balance, it's unlikely they can strike us effectively. And we will be able to strike a lot more effectively than that. Landing, we're trying to charge into it. So I was trying to show you how to manipulate this person's aggression. This is also a very, very good tool for us to learn how to intercept our opponent's strikes. So we don't want to call you about everything. So if I send you for you to practice now, I'm going to hit you here, I'm going to hit you now, 1, 2, 3, I'm going to and then you intercept it. We're not going to get any benefit from this kind of practice with this. We can practice everything in a live manner rather than a dead drill. So we don't tell each other from this, or in a certain way we touch, without choreography, without any expectation, without any preamble movement, we learn how to intercept our opponent's strike. We're going to stick behind for about 5 to 10 minutes, so if you want to talk to us,